हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। दिस इज़ द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन बीबेल गियर्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी सॉल्व अ न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन फोर्स एनालिसिस। दिस न्यूमेरिकल इज आस्क इन एग्जाम यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जामिनेशन फॉर 6 to 7 marks। लेट वी स्टार्ट। एवरीवन clearly read this problem statement. A pair of straight bevel gears has a velocity ratio of 2:1. The pitch circle diameter of pinion is 80 millimeter at the large end of the tooth. 5 kilowatt power is supplied to the pinion that rotates at 800 rpm. The face width is 40 millimeter and the pressure angle is 20 degree. Calculate the tangential, radial and axial components of resultant tooth force acting on pinion and gear meshing teeth. Draw free body diagram of forces acting on pinion and gear. This is the complete problem statement. Now let me solve. First of all, we collect the given data. In this problem statement, velocity ratio is given and that denote by letter small I, that is 2:1. Pitch circle diameter of a pinion is given, that is D suffix P is equal to 80 millimeter. Now here the pitch circle diameter of bevel gear that denoted by letter capital D, but by mistaken here we use a small letter D suffix P. Okay, everyone carefully note down that it is denoted by letter capital D suffix P, 80 millimeter. Now here using velocity ratio and pitch circle diameter of pinion, we get the value of pitch circle diameter of gear. We use the relation of velocity ratio. Velocity ratio is equal to pitch circle diameter of gear divided by pitch circle diameter of pinion. I is equal to D suffix G divided by D suffix P. Okay, I that is equal to 2 is equal to DG divided by 80. Simplify and we get the number of teeth on a gear, that is D suffix G is equal to 160. Here speed of pinion is given 800 rpm. Face width is given 40 millimeter. Pressure angle alpha is given 20 degree. Power is given kilowatt is equal to 5. Now this is the complete given data. This problem is solved in three steps. First of all, we find out the component of resultant tooth force acting on a pinion. This is the step number first. Second step, we find out the component of resultant tooth force acting on a gear. And third step, drawing of a free body diagram. Let me start. Step number first, component of a gear tooth forces on a pinion. Okay. Now here we need a torque, pitch angle for pinion and the mean radius of pinion. That's why first of all we calculate these three important parameters before calculating the component of resultant tooth force. Okay, first of all we find the torque m sub xt, we know the relation, 60 into 10 to the power 6 kilowatt divided by 2 pi n sub xp. Now here substitute all the values in this relation. 60 into 10 to the power 6 into 5 divided by 2 pi into 800. Simplify. After simplification, we get a value of torque m suffix t is equal to 59,683.10366 newton millimeter. Pitch angle gamma. Pitch angle for pinion, that denoted by letter gamma. Tan gamma is equal to Zp divided by Zg or Dp divided by Dg. Okay, we know the teeth is not given, but the diameter is known to you. Pitch circle diameter of pinion is 80 divided by pitch circle diameter of a gear is 160, and take a tan inverse of this relation and we get a pitch circle pitch angle for the pinion gamma is equal to 26.5650 degree. Next, mean radius r suffix m of the pinion. We know the relation for mean radius, r suffix m is equal to inside the bracket d suffix p divided by 2 minus b sine gamma by 2. Now substitute all the values in this relation. D suffix p, that is 80 by 2 minus b 40 sine gamma, sine gamma, that is 26.5650 degree divided by 2. Simplify this. After simplification, we get the value of mean radius r suffix m is equal to 31.0557 millimeter. Now, let me find out the component of resultant tooth force act on a pinion, in which the first component, tangential component, p suffix t. We know the relation for tangential component, p suffix t is equal to m suffix t divided by rm. We know the value of m suffix t and rm, substitute this value in this relation. 109,683.1036 divided by 31.0557. Simplify this. After simplification, we get a tangential component pt is equal to 1921.8083 newton. Second component, radial component, p suffix r. We know the relation for radial component, p suffix r is equal to pt into tan psi into cos gamma. Now substitute the values. Pt 1921.8083 into tan 20 degree into cos 26.5650 degree. Simplify this. After simplification, we get the radial component p suffix r is equal to 625.6351 newton. And the third and last component, axial or thrust component, that is p suffix a. We know the relation for this thrust component, p suffix a is equal to pt into tan alpha into sine gamma. Now substitute the values in this relation. 1921.8083 into tan 20 degree into sine 26.5650 degree. Simplify this. After simplification, we get a value of axial component p suffix a is equal to 312.8168 newton. Step number 2. Components of gear tooth force on gear. Okay, first, in first step we find out the component of resultant tooth force on a pinion. In second step we find out the component of resultant tooth force on gear. Okay, now in a force analysis, these two thing we already discussed. First thing, the radial component on the gear is equal to the axial component on a pinion. Remember, the radial component on the gear is equal to the axial component of the pinion. Second, also the axial component on the gear is equal to the radial component of the pinion. These two things are very important when we find out the component of resultant tooth force act on a gear. Now therefore, the tangential component act on gear, p suffix t, is equal to 1921.8083 newton. Radial component act on a gear, that is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction of axial component act on a pinion. Remember that radial component acting on a gear, that is equal in magnitude and opposite in direction of axial component act on a pinion. Therefore, the radial component act on a gear, that is PR, is equal to 312.8168 newton. and the last component, axial or thrust component, act on a gear, should be equal in magnitude but opposite in direction of a radial component, act on a pinion. Therefore, P suffix A, that is the axial component, act on a gear, that is equal to 625.6351 Newton. This is the step number second. And the last step, step number third, free body diagram. Now for drawing free body diagram, it must to draw bevel pinion and bevel gear, that is shown on the screen, like that, shown on the screen. Okay, now see the pinion we consider as a driving element and gear as a driven element. See the direction of rotation of pinion and direction of rotation of gear. Now here, first of all, we represent the two component on pinion and gear. First component is the tangential component and second is the radial. Okay, now everyone knowing about that tangential component for the driver is opposite to the direction of rotation, that is clearly seen on the pinion. Okay, now the radial component, everyone knowing about that, it is always directed toward the center. Now here the radial component shown toward the center of pinion. Now where it is shown, that is the midpoint of face width. Midpoint of face width. Okay, in force analysis we discussed that resultant forces act at a midpoint of face width. That's why the radial component always show on a midpoint of face width. Okay, that is always directed toward the center. After that, we represent the tangential and radial component on the gear. Now see the direction of rotation of gear, it is a driven, that's why the tangential component same in the direction of rotation, and the radial component, that is knowing to you, it is always directed toward the center. Okay, now here the tangential component and radial component, here we shown on this pinion and gear respectively. After that, important thing is axial component of the pinion and radial axial component of the gear. Now remember that axial component of the pinion is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction of radial component of the gear. That's why here we show this, that axial component act on a pinion opposite to the equal in magnitude but opposite in direction of radial component of a gear. That's why the axial component of a pinion is P suffix A 312.8168. That is clearly shown on this case. And the axial component act on a gear. Remember that. Again, remember this, this thing is very important. Axial component of a gear is equal in magnitude but opposite in direction of radial component of a pinion. That's why here we show the axial component on a pinion like that. 625.6351 Newton, that is the axial component of a pinion. This is the whole problem on a force analysis. This problem is asked for 6 to 7 mark in university examination.